Hi guys, I'm Prateek Singh, and in this video, we're going to learn how the trading terminal works. So all brokers provide you with a trading terminal, which allows you to transact in securities on their platforms. Now, in this case, I'm going to be using Zerodha Kite. The first thing I'll do is log in. Now, I'm provided a client ID and I'll enter my password to log in. After that, I have to enter a PIN. A PIN is basically a two-factor authentication. So I first have a password followed by a PIN that is personal to me. And this is basically for the client's safety. I will enter that PIN and log in to the trading platform. This is the dashboard. It's very simple. On the left side, I can see the total equity, that margin that I have. This is the cash I have in the equity segment. On the right side, I have the commodity account margin. In this case, I don't have money in the commodity account. Right below that is the holdings, where I have all the stocks I have for delivery, for long term, that I have in my Demat account associated with my Kite account. I can see here that there's a P&L, the current value, and the investment value. On the far left side of the dashboard, I can see the Market Watch. This is where you can add all the stocks you want. So I can search for, say, Bajaj Auto and add Bajaj Auto. Notice I have NSE and BSE options to add. So I'll choose NSE in this case, and I'll open the Market Depth. You've already seen the Market Depth a few times by now. So on the left, I have all the bids and different number of orders and the quantity. Quantity is obviously the number of shares. I can also see the total for all of this. And then I have the offer side on the right, again with the offer price, number of orders, and total quantity. If I scroll down, I can see some other information about Bajaj Auto, like the open, high, low, close, and lower circuit and upper circuit of that day. Now, what I'll do is I'll place a buy order on Bajaj Auto. Keep it very simple. All I have to do is specify the quantity. I'll do one single quantity and I'll specify the price. In this case, I'll put this price right here and hit the buy button. So as you can see, the buy order was placed almost instantly, but it wasn't executed because that wasn't the last traded price. We can actually see these orders in the order book right here. So I can see that the order I placed for Bajaj Auto is right here and it's pending. We're waiting for it to get triggered. Now what I'll do is I will go back to Bajaj Auto and place a buy order. But in this case, instead of a limit order, which I had placed earlier, where I specified the price, remember, a limit order is where I can specify the price I want to buy. I will change that limit to a market. Notice when I do that, the price field becomes uneditable because now I'm not specifying the price. In a market order, we are accepting whatever offer is available and the exchange will match that offer to give me the best price possible at that time. So here I'll place one order and hit buy. As you can see, it was placed and executed immediately. We can see that we are now long on this stock, or we have bought Bajaj Auto, and we can see that in the positions tab. We can also see the P&L for this stock right here. Now, if we want to exit this stock, all I need to do is click here and hit exit. The sell window opens. Everything's already there. I'm going to keep it to a market order because I want to exit immediately, and I'll hit sell. And as you can see very quickly, the order was placed and now we have exited Bajaj Auto, the same one that we just bought. Now, let me show you something else. I'm going to search for IDFC First Bank on the NSE. I've added it to my Market Watch and I'm going to place a buy order. This time I won't exit. I will enter at market price and place the order. Now, this stock, as you know, will be credited to my account, to my Demat account, and I'll be able to see it on my console tab and my holdings tab, but I won't show you just yet. It'll actually be credited 2 days later. So as we progress in the video series, I'll actually show you after 2 days that this stock, IDFC First, was credited to my account. There is another tab over here called holdings. The holdings has all the stocks I already own that is credited to my DMAT account. I can see the first stock here. I can see the quantity, the average cost, the LTP and the P&L net change, etc. all on the holdings section. Finally, we are going to explore the back office, which is called console in this case. So if I click here and click on console, the console opens. The console dashboard shows all my holdings in equity, including cash balance. And I can also see the same for commodity. On the top right, this is our menu. I can move to portfolio and see my existing holdings in a nice graphical format where I can see the account, account details, what companies I hold in which sector, and also the split of each individual company right here in this pie chart. Under portfolio, I can also click on IPO and apply for IPOs if there are any available. Then under reports, we have detailed reports on P&L, tax P&L, and other features as well. Under funds, I can place withdrawal requests in case I want to withdraw money to my bank account. Under the account tab, I can see all my details like my client ID, the email address, the PAN number, etc. Just like Bajaj Auto and IDFC Bank, you can also trade in gold, futures and options, etc. But you can also trade in the index itself, like the Sensex or the Nifty. But before we talk about that, what is an index? We'll explore that in the next video. Key takeaways from this video are: